talked about the turnovers, another zero on your staff. What is it about now that you know you're able not to turn the ball over, but to perform big time tonight, 31? And also, Drew over here hit some major big shots for you guys tonight. So what's going to your mind in the second half?
Yeah, just watching a lot of film, you know. I watched a lot of film, especially, you know, coming off ball screens and already knowing what I want to do. So if they're hard hedging, before I come off, already knowing that, so I'm not be surprised. So I feel like before then, when I was turning over the ball, I would come off the screen and then they'll be blitzing me, and then I wouldn't know what to do. But now, you know, I came off, I knew the coverages, I knew everything they were going to do, so I was prepared.
Hey, Boogie, so, you know, today we celebrated the life of Kobe Bryant, and you had a Kobe-like performance in that second half, 27 points, matching UCLA. Just talk to us about just like, you know, the feeling of that, you know, what type of mode were you in?
Yeah, definitely. You know, growing up, Kobe was my favorite player. You know, I watched him. That's who I watched. So, one of my favorite players. I think he's the greatest of all time. But that's another conversation. yeah, but I mean, it's memorable for sure. It really means a lot to me.
Question for both you guys. What was the demeanor like at halftime? And you were in this position 3 weeks ago at Pauley, and you had a great second half, and you almost won the game. So I imagine that you were very confident coming back on the floor for the second 20 minutes. Tell me about the demeanor in the locker room at halftime.
Yeah, for sure. I feel like me and Drew told the guys that we've been in this position before. You know, we're the leaders, so we told them we can't panic. You know, we're gonna come out, we're gonna hit them in the mouth in the second half. You know, forget what happened in the first half. And then, I mean, we've been through it. Me and Drew, we've been playing in big games, played in big atmosphere, so it was really our job to calm the team down.
But you had those couple missed opportunities at the end of the last UCLA game. How determined were you to make sure that, you know, you guys completed the comeback tonight?
Yeah, for sure. I felt like in the UCLA game, it definitely was on me. But it's basketball. You're going to have your highs, you're going to have your lows, but you always got to stay right in the middle. So I'm blessed and I'm glad that I was able to help get this win for my team.
You speak the number 18, and you did it in a pretty exciting fashion, having to come from way behind. How big a deal is this?
I mean, we like I said before, we did this last time. We just weren't able to execute, but when we play them again, I don't want to come from behind again. But it was a big deal.
Drew, was there any moment in particular you knew like Boogie's got it in that second half?
Yeah, definitely. You know, it was especially when you get a guy's hot like that, you just ride it, and we started, you know, calling plays. And I think what was good about tonight is we started attacking mismatches very well. And you know, especially when we kind of haven't shot the ball totally well as a team a lot. When we hit 10 threes, you know, hit nearly a little over 40% of those, we're a really hard team to beat. And you know, you got a guy like Boogie who gets hot like that, you know, just keep getting the mismatches and playing off that. So it was awesome to ride that end of the second half.
What do you think this win over a top 10 team means for your guys' resume and mark?
I mean, it's a good win, you know, but we still got work to do. We still got work to handle. We still got to get better. We still got to, we can't get complacent just because we beat them, you know. We got to, we can't lose any games that we're supposed to win. So we just got to lock in, stay, don't get complacent, and just keep going forward, keep getting better. And it's great to have this win underneath our belt.
Boogie, you had 0 points against UCLA at Galen last center when you upset them. How does it feel to sort of make up for it with the performance like you did tonight?
Yeah, you know, like I said, this game has highs and lows. Tonight was high, but it's a blessing for real. You know, I work hard for these moments. I definitely beat myself up for that performance. But Drew had it rolling. That was his night. So you know, tonight was my night. It's just basketball. This is just how it is.
31 in the college game is not easy. How pleased, proud, how impressed are you with what you were able to do tonight?
I mean, I'm happy, but you know, there's still more work to do. Tomorrow's a new day, so this will all be over. We got I'm enjoying it tonight, but you know, we got Washington next.
Drew, what did you do differently in the second half on defense? Because it seemed like you really locked them down, both inside and outside.
Right, definitely. Yeah, we were giving up too many threes early on, and you know, a big thing for us was you know, rebounding that second half, and I think we limited them on the boards, and I don't know what the end totals were, but you know, we were getting killed at halftime, just like the first half at Pauley last time. So you know, we really locked in. You know, we held the, you know, some of the best players to you know, lower than their averages, and you know, it's great to deal with execute like we did that second half at Pauley, but this time get the win on the back end.
Boogie, that step back three to make it 65-56, it just kind of looked like you had that a look in your eye, like it was going up and you were never going to miss that shot. Can you break down that play and how good it felt to go in? Do you feel like that was a dagger shot in this game?
Oh yeah, for sure it was a dagger, but I work on that shot all the time, so I wasn't really surprised. I knew when I got the ball, if he was going to play back, that I was going to go to that move, but I work on that all the time, so it's just, you know, repetition.
My Boogie, Drew. What are you guys' thoughts on the atmosphere today? Like, it was an amazing crowd here for you guys in this rival game. Like, how much did that energize you guys, especially there in the second half?
Yeah, it's great. It's awesome, you know, especially coming out, a little bit of a deficit in halftime, and the crowd stayed in it, and, just got louder by the point for us, and, we were really trying to wave our arms and get everybody going, and those type of games, it's such an advantage when we can get a crowd like that. You know, it's such an advantage for us home at Gale Center, and, I give all credit to the fans for showing up and showing out for, a huge game for us.
Any more questions?
Yeah, last thing.
All right, last
does
one.
Does this game show really how good you are? Perhaps in a lot of eyes, your record or whatever is not where it could be or should be, but this game really shows your true colors, how good this team is?
I mean, it's a start. Honestly, I don't feel that way. I feel that we still got more to prove. Winning one game versus UCLA is great, and it's great for the rivalry, but I still feel like we got more to prove. We gotta try to get one against, try to keep winning, and we need to get that one at the end of the year versus Arizona.
Dre, you're only one game out of first place now in the conference. Is that something you're keeping your eye on, try to win the conference in the regular season?
For sure, obviously, that's, the first goal in mind is to take care of the conference regular season, then obviously the Pac-12 tourney, then potentially a tourney run. But it's a big thing, we're taking a step at a time because, each game weighs the same, so we got to take care of next week, defend our home court again, and, just keep moving along. Like Boogie said, tomorrow's a new day, and we got to take care of next week.
All right, thank you, guys.
Thank you.